listening, feeling blue. I'm listening, feeling sad, feeling mad, feeling bad, feeling glad. I'm listening.
You don't need an original tune. You want something that'll bore a hole through the public's little pea brain.
I was mesmerized by your show business savvy.
Do you ever feel like you just like to go straight?
What?
Well, you know, I was walking home and I kept thinking about all the turns we have to make. Right turn, left turn. How much easier it'd be if we just could go straight over the trees, over a building. That's what a giant would do. They should let everybody be a giant for a day. Barbecue pudding chips.
No, thanks.
They look at me funny in the store, too, but you taste that and tell me that's not better than a woman. Why am I putting these chips in this pudding?
Well, I was gonna say.
You should be dumping the pudding in with the chips. You know, I've been having these great ideas all day. I wrote some of them down. Here. What do you think this means? Dog army. Hi, Frasier.
Dad, where are your pants?
In the fridge. I had a reason. Fridge pants.
Dad, when you were at the cafe today, you didn't eat a brownie that Roz brought for Niles, did you?
Yeah, but I replaced him.
For God's sake! That was a pot brownie. You're stoned off your ass.
Dad, you know, this could go either way.
Oh, yeah, I know. Don't worry about it. I'm not going to act like one of those saps I always make fun of. Doesn't matter if it's worth $2 or $2,000. I'm just going to say, that's pretty much what I figured.
What can you tell us about this pewter clock?
Well, it is a clock set in the stomach of what appears to be a bear.
Actually, it's much more than that. It's Russian, made in the mid-19th century.
That's pretty much what I figured.
Actually, it's a stunning piece. It was made by Andrei Karagin, who worked for Tsar Alexander II.
That is pretty much what I figured.
I don't know if you're descended from the Romanovs, Martin, but all of Karagin's known bear clocks were done exclusively for the Romanov family and are now in the Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg. Martin, you may be surprised to learn that this clock at auction would easily bring $25,000.
Ka-ching!
What he means is, that's pretty much what we figured.
Somebody get me a beer!
Holy moly, Niles, this is unbelievable!
You like it?
Oh, I love it! Frasier said to come as your hero, not as the handsomest man in the world.
You actually told Emily's mother that you were gay?
Well, you said not to offend her. I thought that was a pretty good way to get her to cool her jets without hurting her feelings.
Dad, something you don't understand, you see. She told Emily.
Oh, I get it. You worried she'll know I'm straight and find out I've been lying to her mother.
Dad?
Oh, well, don't worry about it. I'll gay it up a little. Emily, have I told you I love your hair?
Oh. Thank you, Martin.
It's divine.
Were you in the arts?
Oh, well, actually, Ed...
Dad was a cop.
Really? Mm-hmm.
The uniform and everything?
Yeah, in fact, that's what happened to my hip. I took a bullet trying to break up a robbery. Yeah, I called for backup, but it never showed up.
Oh, because you were gay.
Don't think I didn't wonder about that. Yes, that was the day I came out, lying in that alley covered with blood, bullet in my hip, and I said, that's it, I'm gay, I like myself, and I'm not living a lie anymore.
I had exactly the same experience when I came out.
Say, do you feel like getting a drink?
Yeah, that'd be nice, Marty.
Okay. You know, this is such a prime spot here. I think maybe one of us should stay here and the other one get the drinks.
You're right.
So I'll have a beer.
Okay. Oh, shoot, I think I lost an earring.
Oh, there it is, butterfoot. There you go.
Thanks. Enjoy the party.
What is it?
Well, you gotta get me home.
Why?
Well, something's happened with my hair dye. It's melting or something. Look at this stain. It must look terrible.
No, it doesn't. Actually, it looks terrific.
You sure?
Well, maybe the fire is making it perspire just a little bit.
Yeah.
Well, actually, you look quite young and attractive, actually. That's, you know, by the warmth of the fire glow, I'd say that you actually look like you're back in your Marty party days.
You're not BSing me.
No.
Okay, then, I'll stay.
Great.
Someone followed me again last night.
Ah, you're just being paranoid.
I'm telling you, they're onto me.
Come on, nobody could recognize you after all that plastic surgery.
What Marlena thought.
Marlena got sloppy. She never should have gone back to Zurich.
Just don't want any more bloodshed.
Relax. You're home free.
You don't know the woodchuck and his ways.
We are. You are. The woodchuck and his ways.
You know, we really should stop doing this. It's not nice.
Yeah, you're right. We won't do it anymore.
How'd you get the stuff through customs?
They never checked the wooden leg.
Why don't you start here, Good night. And okay. I want to hear you really attack the note.
Okay. Oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine.
You see, the principle is to distract yourself with a physical exercise, thus freeing the voice. You hit one note, and you slide up the octave as you descend slowly into a crouched position. Observe. Oh. You see, it works.
Very interesting. I wonder if the reverse is true.
No!
Try it, Dad. No, I'm afraid with three of us doing it, it might look stupid.
I'm starting to think your problem's all psychological. No. I think you've convinced yourself you can't hit this note.
Yeah, I convinced the guy upstairs, too.
No, I think Niles may be right, Dad. You just need some positive reinforcement. Let's try it again. And this time, try to eliminate any negative thoughts.
Okay.
All right, let's go a little
earlier, right.
Niles.
Right.
Fall on your knees. Let's try
it. Fall on your knees.
Fall on your knees.
You've got it, Dad.
Oh, here.
I hear sweet music.
The angel voice.
I hear one angel.
Oh, no.
Lovely night.
Divine.
Divine.
Oh, night, yeah. When Christ was born.
A star is born.
Oh, night.
Bring it home now.
Divine.
Oh, shut up.
That takes me back. Of course, your coat was a lot shinier in those days. Hell, so was mine. we were something, weren't we, Agadez, huh? Riding crowd control? People just step aside to let us pass? Now they're putting you out to pasture, and I'm riding the buses. Yeah, it's fun getting old, isn't it? Hey, but this is a nice place here, you know? I bet you're really gonna like it here. And you know,
If you don't like it here, then we'll do what we said we would. We'll just go to Montana, start a ranch. You know, we still got all that money we took from those drug dealers buried in the old box canyon.
All right, Dad, we know you know we're here.
You were right.
Maybe we let our problems get to us a bit too much.
Well, hell yes. If they're the worst of your problems, you're lucky. I got a bullet in my hip, a girlfriend who's too good for me and might realize it any day, a dog who's pushing 80 in human years, and I'm not far behind him. But you don't hear me making a fuss, do you? Know why? Because I focus on what's good about my life. You know what you people should do? Let's tell them, Ronnie.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. Can be complete on the sunny side of the street.
I used to walk in the shade with my blues on parade, but I'm not afraid of this rover crossed over. If I never have a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. Dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street.
All right, stop it.
What?
I don't want to watch myself make out with Elton John. Okay, I got it.
Beer and pretzels, that's our game. That's our game, that's our game. Beer and pretzels, that's our game. C-H-E-R-S.
What's the matter, babe?
You can't work with a man you're attracted to?
Oh, God.
Hey, that's my boy. Yes. Come on.
Oh. Are you sure you want a little of this on the side? I can scoop around the Lucky Charms.
No, thanks.